Hello and welcome, guys. My name's an average American, and today I'm going to be asking the question, should abortion be legal? So, I've been doing more political-oriented videos recently, this is a hot topic. So I figured, you know what? Okay, well, let's break this down. Protect a woman's life. I could agree with that. If a woman is going to die from having the child or birthing the child, then yeah, abortion makes sense to keep that woman alive. Terminate pregnancy from rape. I agree with that point completely. Terminate fetus with congenital disabilities. I don't necessarily agree with that, but I could see why you would consider that an option. 47,000 women died from unsafe abortions in 2008. That's another argument for the pro-choice side. Now, let's just go pro-life. It's like the pro-life argument. Who you want to be first? Pro-life argument. Regular people have the right to live. The fetus is a distinct human from the moment of conception. Unless the woman's life is in danger, a woman have the duty not to kill their unborn babies. You fucking retarded. Murder should be illegal in a moral society. Murder is illegal because murder entitles that you are killing a person from the moment of conception. So does that mean if I jizz on a rag, then I'm killing children? Because conception, I would assume that means the second that jizz hits the inside of the woman's vagina, right? Fetus is a distinct human from the moment of conception. I think I got this wrong, actually. Never mind. I think I messed up the meaning of the word. Let's just look this up. Conception. Conceiving a child or being conceived. Okay, so no, I was right. Having sex. I was right. Reasons for given abortion. Concern for responsibility to other individuals, not wanting their lives changed by the birth of a baby. Well, if you have the choice to, if it was either, in my opinion, I'm gonna give my opinion here, trigger warning, because this is kind of a meshing opinion with both sides, but I believe if a woman was raped, or if she can't support the child, and the child would be in a abusive or non-capable to raise the child properly environment, then an abortion is a completely feasible and understandable option. Not wanting their lives changed by the birth of a baby, here's the problem with that, you chose to have sex. This is assuming that the person who is choosing the abortion route did have consensual sex. So if you don't want your life changed by a baby, you could always not have sex or wear a condom. Unplanned or unwanted, again, you can't unplanned or unwanted, not really, because you could always wear a condom, right? Relationship problem, you could always split up and then just, you know, 1 week with the kid, 1 week without the kid. That just makes sense to me. Pregnancy is the result of crime. I'm a little confused. Are you saying rape? Because crime, that's a very broad definition. Unacceptable quality of life. Yeah. Pro-life argument. Here we go. This is defined as the responsibility or obligation of the government to perceive all human life, regardless of intent, viability, or quality of life concerns. Abortion is murder, pro-life. Let's break this down. This is defined as the responsibility or obligation of the government to preserve all human life. Okay, I personally don't believe the government has any right saying or dictating to women that they shouldn't or should do certain things with their body. I don't believe the government has a place there. I do think they have a place when it happens to come to people who are killing babies for almost no reason. Now, I don't believe that women who, even if it is an accident, I don't believe that those women would go through an abortion because it was an accident. I think women go through abortions for much deeper reasons, such as rape, or they can't take care of the child properly. Because I couldn't imagine an abortion as something someone could easily go through, because that's still even though the baby isn't fully developed, that still is gonna take a mental toll on the person who's getting the abortion. Let's see another one. Standard pro-life argument. P1. The fetus, you spelled fetus wrong. The fetus is an innocent human being. It is morally wrong to end the life of an innocent human being. I agree with P2. It is morally wrong to end the life of a fetus. What are we defining as a human being? Let's look this up. Human. Let's look up the definition of human. Human definition, bada bing, bada bing. Relating characteristics of people or human beings. Okay, so the fetus has to have a personality, basically, from this definition. A human being, especially a person, as distinguished from an animal or, in science fiction, an alien. So, basically, they have to be a human. As in, they have to have a personality, apparently, due to this definition, and they have to be especially a person distinguished from an animal. So I'm guessing that means they speak language, they understand society, right? Makes sense to me, makes sense to you, hopefully. Now let's look at an article and see what they begins at conception. So unborn babies are human beings with a right to life. I don't agree with the life begins at conception. Because wouldn't that technically mean that, let's just say, someone didn't have the strongest swimmers, right? Fucking cunt. It is 12:30 a.m. and the dude's just driving down the street with his bass boosted. What a cunt. Shout out to the cunt outside in my neighborhood. He's a cunt. Let's get back to the concept here. So unborn babies are human beings with a right to life. I don't believe so. I believe fetuses are, I'm not sure if I would consider a fetus a human being. It's very tricky because the definition of human being is a little hard to determine with a fetus. Personhood begins after a fetus becomes viable, able to survive outside the womb, or after birth, not at conception. Fetuses feel pain during the abortion procedure. Well, they're dying. Psychological damage. Modern abortion procedures are safe and do not cause lasting health issues such as cancer and infertility. How do these mesh up? This is physical issues and these are psychological issues. I don't think you can kind of pin these against each other like you are trying to. Abortions reduce the number of adoptable babies. Women who receive abortions are less likely to suffer mental health problems than women denied abortions. Well, women who receive abortions are less likely to suffer mental health problems. Okay, fair point. Abortions reduce the number of adoptable babies. I think if we reduce the number of adoptable babies, that might help us later on. since we do have quite an adoption problem. Too many kids aren't getting adopted. So what's the harm in stopping the flow of children? Also, it says given up for adoption in the United States declined from 9% of those before 1973 to 1% of those born between 1996 and 2002. I wouldn't think that's that big of a difference, to be honest. So anyways, guys, I'll wrap up with my point. And my point basically is, to get back to the original argument, is that I believe, as a person, or in my view, that a woman has a right to an abortion. She should be able to get an abortion legally. I believe she should have to pay for the abortion. I don't believe that it should be a state-funded abortion. I believe that if a woman I believe that abortions are really only acceptable in the cases of rape, the incapability to take care of the child properly, the incapability to fund the child properly, such as if someone lives below the poverty line, and if you don't have, let's just say you have a woman who got pregnant, but she is in like a very bad mental state where she might end up killing the baby or herself. That's another reasonable situation for an abortion. I do not believe that women who, pretty much only because they can afford it and they really don't want to put aside their education or work, and they did it consensually, I don't believe they have the right to an abortion, because they still made the end decision to have sex unprotected. So anyways, guys, if you guys have an opinion or want to argue with me, comment down below your argument. I'll feel free to have a discussion with me or say your opinion. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. My name's Nigel Nick. Peace. 1, 2, 3, I like good pussy and I like good trees. Smoke so much weed, you wouldn't believe. And I get more ass than a toilet seat. 3 to the 1, 1 to the 3. I met a bad bitch last night in the DMV.